Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Cell Division. In that we are studying topic, what is mitotic division? When I say mitotic division, it is equal division, same carbon copy or you can say Xerox copy of a parent. Today we'll be seeing how and where does it occur. Meiotic division, or you can say mitosis. During mitotic division, what happens is it is called as equal division. When I say equal division, if the parent is diploid, then the daughters will also be diploid. If the parent is 2n, then the daughters will also be 2n. It's nothing but Xerox or carbon copy. That is what mitotic division is. During mitotic division, what happens is the daughter During mitotic division, what happens is the parent divides in such a fashion or in such a manner that the chromosome number is exactly duplicated into the parent cell. Mitotic divisions basically take place in somatic cells. When I say somatic cells, this could be your lung cells, your kidney cells, your stomach cells, etc. During all the phases, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, all these four phases takes place during mitotic division. The chromosomes align, spindle fibers form, the centriole come, the chromosomes segregate, go back to their respective places. Karyokinesis as well as cytokinesis, both are the part of mitotic division. Mitotic division starts with G1 phase, G2 phase, S phase, which is the synthesis phase, and then the M phase, which is the mitotic phase, take place, in which first karyokinesis, that is nothing but nucleus divides, and then cytokinesis takes place, which is the division of cytoplasm. When the division of cytoplasm takes place, organelles basically divide. The most important thing about mitosis is that it makes the genetic material, or you can say the somatic cell, all the somatic cells in your body same. Imagine you don't want to have an RBC, or you can say for example a phagocytic cell or a basophil cell which has 46 number of chromosome, and after cell division a basophil cell comes which has 23 number of cells. That won't work, or you can say reduction in chromosomes won't work. During mitosis, that is taken care of, that diploidy or diploid structures or cells are formed. Mitosis also takes place during the process of reproduction, but during the process of reproduction, the first thing that takes place is meiosis, and then mitosis takes place. Mitosis takes place once the fertilization is done and the egg is implanted, and now it is the child who's growing inside the womb of a mother, especially the growing years or the growing months when the hands, legs, all these parts are developing. Obviously cells need to divide, and at that time mitosis is taking place. Even if there's a cut on your hand, your cells need to repair. The type of cell division there is nothing but mitosis. If there is some amount of blood loss from your body during operations, etc., or anything, the type of cell division that will take place in your body would be mitosis, the somatic cell division, or you can say the equal division. mitotic division. When we talk about mitotic division, what I'm trying to say is mitotic division is, it is a process in which the parent cell or the mother cell divides in such a manner that it produces two new daughter cells that are genetically identical or that have same number of chromosomes, which is diploid. During mitosis, each body cell will have same genetic material, or mitosis makes it happen. The diploidy of the chromosome is maintained during mitosis. If there are 46 number of chromosomes, the daughter will have 46. If there are 2n number of chromosomes in parent, then the daughter will have 2n number of chromosomes inside itself. This mitotic division takes place during reproduction also, in the reproductive phase also, in the later stage. And in somatic cells, it always takes place. Let us see how the process of mitosis takes place inside a cell. During the process of mitosis, the parent cell will have chromosomes, and these chromosomes will undergo the process of replication. That is, they'll become diploid in number or 2n in number. And once they have become diploid, then the daughter cells are formed, and these daughter cells will be distributed same number of chromosomes as the parent cell. So in short, the parents first duplicate its number of chromosomes, and after the duplication of its number of chromosomes, then the daughters are given same number of chromosomes. So if this is diploid, then the daughters will also be diploid, or if this is 46, then the daughters will also be 46. But the process of replication has to take place for that to happen, or basically the DNA has to undergo replication process for mitosis to happen. Students, in this part of the chapter, what you have studied is about mitosis and how mitosis plays an important role and where mitosis takes place. I hope you all are clear about this concept. Thank you.